How many Kindle books can I read in a day? Christmas edition. First book. These books are short, so I'll read a few. Next one. The letters I love. An 80-page book, yes please. Third book. I feel so Christmassy. Last one. Vlogmas break. This one's probably my favorite from today.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, but the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot.
The book I have to share with you this evening is most unseasonal, but it is so rare that you can't pick and choose when you might acquire a copy. And that's why tonight I'm going to tell you about the first edition of the most famous Christmas book ever written. This is a first edition of Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol from 1843. Conceived as a Christmas gift, it is beautifully presented, bound in a red cloth with gilt decorations to the spine and cover. This might not seem like much to us, but it's very lavish for the time, and this is the first Dickens book to have gilt titles to its front cover. The end papers are a Christmassy green and prone to discoloration, so were dropped from later issues. It was published on the 19th of December and sold through 6,000 copies before Christmas Eve. You might have imagined that such an instant bestseller would have been hugely lucrative to Dickens, but no expense was spared in the book's production, with that lovely gilt binding and hand-coloured illustrations. So he had to make do with a mere £137, which can't have impressed his Scroogish side very much.